Could the Milky Way be rippling with life and intelligence, worlds calling out to worlds, while we on Earth are alive at the critical moment when we first decide to listen? Our species has discovered a way to communicate through the dark, to transcend immense distances. No means of communication is faster or cheaper or reaches out farther. It's called radio. We are now on an unprecedented scale, listening for radio signals from possible other civilizations in the depths of space. This quest is called the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, S-E-T-I, pronounced SETI. Let me describe how far we've come. The first SETI program was carried out by Frank Drake. His great achievement was to show that modern technology is fully able to listen for signals from hypothetical civilizations on the planets of other stars. Meanwhile, the technology for detection has been getting cheaper, the sensitivity keeps improving, the scientific respectability of SETI has continued to grow, but our fear of the dark rebels. The idea of alien beings troubles us. We conjure up objections. It's too expensive, some of us say. But in its fullest modern technological expression, it costs less than one attack helicopter a year. We'll never understand what they're saying, some of us say. But because the message is transmitted by radio, we and they must have radio physics, radio astronomy, and radio technology in common. The laws of nature are the same everywhere. So science itself provides a means and language of communication, even between very different kinds of beings, provided they both have science. All through human history, some of us say, advanced civilizations have ruined civilizations just slightly more backward. Certainly. But malevolent aliens, should they exist, will not discover our existence from the fact that we listen. The search programs only receive. They do not send. After billions of years of biological evolution, on their planet and ours, an alien civilization cannot be in technological lockstep with us. There have been humans for more than 20,000 centuries, but we've had radio only for about one century. If alien civilizations are behind us, they're likely to be too far behind to have radio. And if they're ahead of us, they're likely to be far ahead of us. Think of the technical advances in our world over just the last few centuries. What is, for us, technologically difficult or impossible? What might seem to us like magic might for them be trivially easy. We could communicate today across much of the galaxy. They should be able to do much better, if they exist.